this I did. So I packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something to show you how we live. Everybody want it, but it ain't that serious. That's that. So if you gon' do it just like this. Did you
realize that you are a champion? Only fitting to play Champion by Kanye West because we just had Championship Sunday. Wow. So let's go ahead and get into it. Good morning, everybody. Happy Monday to all of you beautiful, amazing, blessed individuals. Oh man, it's time for us to get out of our dreams. It's time for us to make our dreams become a reality. And why not start today? Why not make today the day where, you know what, you change your fortunes, that you take that risk that you've been going back and forth about? Why not? Why not use today as a tool to get better, to challenge yourself to, you know what, be the best person that you can be? Man, thank God it's Monday. It's a beautiful day, beautiful week, and we're all blessed and fortunate to wake up. Don't let this day go by without, you know, showing your gratitude, showing humility, showing love to others. So go ahead and go after it. And man, okay, this is the breakdown. X's and O's with Nate Ness. I'm your host, Nate Ness, and man, Championship Sunday. Amazing. And man, we're treated to some great and amazing spectacular games. I mean, one thing I've stressed this whole season, and I reiterated, once the postseason had begun, is that, you know what, you cannot start a game fast and just finish sloppy. Not finish. And we had a couple of those moments on this Championship Sunday. Man, I mean, when a team comes out in the first half and they start off strong, you just looking like, wow, okay, man, this might be one of those games. But when they come out that second half lackadaisical, leaving like, you know, okay, just believing that they've already won the game, when the game is actually a tale of two different halves, you can be Jekyll in one half and come out and be Hyde the next. So again, gotta stay the course. You gotta play a complete game. There's two halves, a complete game. So, man, let's go ahead. Let's start this first. We're going to Arrowhead, AFC Championship game. Kansas City Chiefs, Kansas City Chiefs, host the Cincinnati Bengals. Now, this game was very exciting, and it was just phenomenal. The Chiefs, they came out smoking. Like I said before, it's starting off fast. And you want to start off fast in these games. In all games, you want to start off fast. But it's not about how you start. It's more so less about how you finish. You know, that's what it's all about. It's that you can start fast, but you got to finish strong. You know, and they came out like built. They came out and built a 21-10 lead going into the halftime. And you thought at the moment that this game was going to get out of hand because, again, Cincinnati at the first half, they couldn't keep up with that scoring pace of Patrick Mahomes and that Chiefs offense. But going into the half, the Chiefs did leave some points on the field. Now, this is one thing I do not agree with Coach Reed. Sometimes you got to be smart. You can't leave points on the field. And Kansas City actually left at least 3 points on the field before halftime as they went for, you know what, they tried to get a touchdown before the half instead of taking the secure 3 points. But it proved to be a costly decision. And they were stopped. Now, Patrick Mahomes, he looked great in the first half. Like, I mean, he was making all types of plays and throws. He led the Chiefs on 3 different scoring drives. And just, again, he just looked good. He looked poised in the pocket. I mean, but again, it's a tale of two halves. The second half, he came out and he was just completely a different player. And when I mean a completely different player, he just looked sloppy. You know what? And the Chiefs, offensively, they didn't have no answer. They just looked like, you know what, they gave their all in that first half and came out and just left everything in halftime. You know, and one of the things that's very questionable, besides the play calling and the adjustments that they made, this Chiefs team was only held to 3 points in the second half. Now, Patrick finished the game 26 for 39 for 275 yards, 3 touchdowns, 2 interceptions. And those 2 interceptions both came in the second half. Now, this is a game where you gotta make adjustments. And I commend the adjustments that the Bengals made going into halftime and limiting this offense. And when I say limiting this offense, the Chiefs did not convert not 1/3 down in that second half. So you got to give credit where credit is due. The Bengals defense came out, stayed the course, and they really gave the Chiefs a game. Now, Jerick McKinnon led the Chiefs on the ground with 12 carries for 65 yards. And the head scratcher about this is the Chiefs had 3 receivers produce solid numbers in the first half. But But that was just it. They produced in the first half. Travis Kelce led the way with 10 receptions for 95 yards and one touchdown. Tyreek Hill, the Cheetah, had 7 receptions for 78 yards and another touchdown. And Mecole Hardman had 3 receptions for 52 yards and a touchdown. Now, again, that's it. Now, all this production in the first half, but there was nothing in the second. Now, on the other side of the ball, I mean, again, this Bengals team, if we're going to say anything, this team is a true team that has battled back. You know, the true definition of resiliency. You know, to be down, but to not give up, to stay the course. This is a, you know, that's a perfect, you know, they're the perfect example of boxers. You know, it's not about how hard you can hit as a boxer, but it's how hard you can get hit and keep coming and keep coming forward. How many times can you get knocked down and get back up? And that's what they've done all year long. Joe Burrow has been cool kid Joe, has been so calm and so confident. And that's what a true leader is. Playing that quarterback position where you're the face of the franchise and you're expected to lead this offense, that's exactly what he did. He was calm, cool, and collected. Stayed the course, didn't let nothing rattle him. Just again, one play at a time, one drive at a time. And that's how the Bengals was able to get back into this game. He struggled in the first half. But the second half, he was completely different. The Bengals were a completely different team. Burrow finished the game 23 for 38 for 250 yards, 2 touchdowns, 1 interception, while also carrying the ball 5 times for 25 yards. And he converted some big, big, big third downs. Was able to escape the pocket, escape some short sacks, and was able to extend drives for this team and keep that Chiefs defense on the field. Now, Joe Mixon, he ran hard and he ran strong. You know, it got 21 carries for 88 yards for Mr. Mixon. But you got a big game, and I'm talking about a really, really huge game from T. Higgins, in my opinion. He was big down the stretch, and he led the team, making some big catches to really set the team up for that game-winning drive. He finished the game with 6 receptions for 103 yards and just was, again, using that big body, just dominating all over the field. All-Pro Ja'Marr Chase, he chipped in with 6 receptions for 54 yards and 1 touchdown. And he really got going in the second half, as in the first half, he was held to 2 receptions for 8 yards. And you just got to respect that they just kept going, so they found a way to get him the ball. Samaje Perine, he chipped in 3 receptions for 43 yards and 1 touchdown. And his touchdown, actually, in my opinion, along with the defensive stop going into halftime, was what gave this Bengals team the energy and start to swing the momentum to their favor. You know, again, as I said before, the Chiefs came out strong, but this Bengals team, they stayed the course. I commend Coach Zach Taylor and his staff of just, again, being calm. Stay the course, one drive at a time, one play at a time, because you're not going to all get all the points back at one moment. You just got to stay calm and stay the course. And Kansas City, they forced, like, you know, I really, I'm at a loss for words, because You're a team that just really high-powered offense can score and get going like that, like wildfire. But you guys really laid an egg up by 11 points, and you allowed the Bengals to come right back. And again, Kansas City forced the game into overtime. And you're thinking at the coin toss, man, it's about to be another game very similar to last week against Buffalo. As KC won the toss, and you just thought, man, this is about to be a repeat, as Joe Burrow sat on that sideline in just agony, hoping that his defense could make a play. But it didn't go that way. The Chiefs did not get the win. The Bengals actually got a big, big play as Patrick Mahomes, you know what, again, made an ill-advised throw, and the Bengals were able to make an interception. And they got the ball to cool kid Joe in overtime. And he took the Bengals 9 plays, 42 yards, to set up a 31-yard Evan McPherson game-winning field goal to send the Bengals to the first Super Bowl in 33 years, 27-24. And I must say congratulations to the Bengals. There's nothing like, you know, again, that was a beautiful game, an amazing game. It was a game exciting, thrilling. I mean, it was an excellent chess match. But the game ball goes to the defensive coordinator, Lou Anarumo. Hope I didn't butcher your name, Coach Lou, and his staff for the adjustments that they made, and that, again, this defense just, again, they stiffed and they blanketed this Chiefs offense at halftime. And I got to give, like, you know, some of the blame, I got to give it to Andy Reid and Patrick Mahomes. Andy Reid for, again, what adjustments did you make coming into the second half? And you got lax. Patrick Mahomes, I mean, again, you got too pretty. You got to, again, this is the time of the year where, you know, teams are gambling. Your leads, there is no such thing as a big lead because teams are battling back and coming back. And I feel that the Chiefs actually left this on the table and the Bengals came and took it. So congratulations to Joe Burrow. And most importantly, congratulations to Coach Zach Taylor. Third year, you know, getting this team to the Super Bowl. And wasn't even expected to even be as far as they were. Congratulations. This is a true Cinderella story, a true underdog story. And congratulations to Coach Taylor. Congratulations to the Bengals. And we'll see you in the Super Bowl.
All right.
All right. Now, this was the most exciting game. This is the game we was waiting for. The NFC Championship. Now, we're going to close out this NFC Championship Sunday with a huge game. We're talking about a rivalry here. This is the matchup between David and Goliath. David being the Rams, who are hosting the NFC West rivals, the San Francisco 49ers, who is Goliath. And NFC West, NFC Championship. This game was perfect to close out the evening. With so many headlines going into this game, with the Rams going against a team that they haven't beaten 3 years, essentially. Yes, the 49ers have owned the Rams for the past three seasons. And man, this game was a classic slugfest between both teams. Both teams came out ready to play. The Niners, they came out strong and played very good and tough game. Now, Jimmy G, for the most part, was good until the closing moments of the game. He missed a couple of throws in the earlier parts of the game, but settled down and was able to get into the flow of the game. Garoppolo finished it 16 for 30 for 232 yards, two touchdowns, one interception. And the 49ers, they really, again, what we know of the 49ers is that they're a team that can run the ball. When you think of Shanahan, you think of that zone running scheme, a team that's going to run the ball, control the clock. Running the ball is going to help your quarterback because that's going to open up the play action pass. That's going to open up what your offensive playbook and whatnot. It's going to allow you to control the clock and can dictate the game, keeping the defense on the field, keeping the offense off the field. But the 49ers, they couldn't get the running game going. And we got to commend the Rams for literally their run defense and not allowing it to get going. Deebo Samuel, Mr. Do-It-All, he had a solid day of production, carrying the ball seven times for 26 yards and four receptions for 72 yards and one touchdown. George Kittle, he didn't have a big game and didn't have the big numbers, but he did finish the game with two receptions for 27 yards and one touchdown. But the Rams, on the other hand, this is a team that, the confidence, you know what, again, you're excited to be playing against your division rival. You want to finally, you know what, get over that hump. Again, to play a team, you know, it's hard to beat a team twice in a season. And San Fran has done that for 3 years straight. But to attempt to do that a third time, the odds have always been in favor of the team that's the underdog. Now, this team, the Rams have been, up and down. I mean, a team that, you know what, hey, they've weathered the storms. They've had storms during the season. They've weathered them. You know, they're just still trying to get their feet wet or figure stuff out. But they've been a team that has battled and battled and battled and battled. The one thing I said before the game was the most important position, or before the season, was the most important position that the Rams needed to address with the quarterback position. With the championship defense that they have, man, only thing they needed was to get a solid signal caller to lead this team. And they did that. They felt the missing piece was a quarterback to get them over the hump. And this team, like many other teams, like Cincinnati, has been a team of resiliency that has battled, that has taken its bumps on the road and just continued to fight, continued to stand up, and just didn't go down. Matthew Stafford, man, my former teammate, so excited to see him out there on that field, so excited to see him going. Now, he didn't start out the game pretty good, as the Rams had drove down to the red area and he threw a red zone interception. But that didn't deter them. You know, they went into halftime down 10-7. And then they were down 10 points going into the fourth quarter. But Matt calmed down and he led this team. It was important that McVay got the team calm, weathered that storm, and just really focused on, hey, we got a game to play. We got to focus. Matt finished the day 31 for 45 for 337 yards, two touchdowns, one interception. As I said before, in order for the Rams to win this game, Matt was going to have to play his best game. and he played a great game. And another thing I stated was that Coach McVay, he was going to have to, like, you know, be good. He was going to have to get into a good rhythm early and with his play call, with the mixing in the run with the pass. Now, the Rams were the team that seems to be able to run the ball. Cam Akers led the way with 13 carries for 48 yards. And, I mean, again, they got going early. You know, it got going. And as the game progressed, they were actually able to make some plays. Another thing that I stated before was that the Rams were going to need their stars to step up in a big way. And their wide receivers, Cooper Kupp and OBJ, Odell Beckham Jr., they did that, and they did that in a big way. With Cooper Kupp leading the way with 11 receptions, 442 yards, and 2 touchdowns, and Odell Beckham chipping in 9 receptions, 413 yards. Both of these guys showed up, especially down the stretch, and especially on that final game-winning drive. But being down 10 points going into the fourth quarter, man, this team changed the narrative and showed so much heart. I mean, I'm talking about big heart. And made all of the big crucial plays down the stretch, scoring 13 points in the fourth quarter with Matt Stafford leading the way on a 10-play, 49-yard drive that ate up 4 minutes and 40 seconds of the clock to set up a big Matt Gay 30-yard field goal for the Rams to take a 20-17 lead in the fourth quarter with 1 minute and 46 seconds left. And the 49ers, they got the ball. They got the ball back, 146, man. You're thinking they're going to go down there and drive. You know, hey, we're about to see something. This is what the game, this is what quarterbacks, this is what if you're a competitor, this is what you want to see. 1 minute on the clock, who's going to make the play? Is it going to be the offensive team that's going to make the play or the defensive side of the ball? I'm a defender. Love seeing the defense going out there. It's pride. You got to have pride. You got to have a sense of urgency. You got to have a sense of just want to and drive and passion that we're not going to allow this team to take what's ours. And Aaron Donald, even though he had a pretty quiet day, being doubled and triple teamed the whole day, he made probably the biggest play of the game as he got pressure on Jimmy G and forced him to throw a game-sealing interception to Travon Howard to push the Rams into Super Bowl 56, where they will host the Cincinnati Bengals. And this is the second year in a row where the hosting teams, the Super Bowl hosting team or hosting city, their team will be in the Super Bowl. And this game was just, again, amazing game. Got to give a game ball to Coach McVay. Got to give a game ball to the defense, the Ram defense, for stepping up in a big way. And Matthew Stafford, the offense. This is a great team victory. But stepping up and answering the call. Changing the narrative. Yes, the San Francisco 49ers, you guys haven't beat them in 3 years. But changing the narrative. Surrendering, like, you know, giving up a 17-point lead in that week 16 matchup, but changing the narrative, not allowing that to dictate the season, believing in the team and the team playing for the man next to him. You got to love it. I kind of have to put this loss, though, on Kyle Shanahan. Kyle Shanahan, he got away from, you know, the bread and butter. You have Deebo Samuel. Deebo Samuel only touched the ball 11 times. You got to get this man the ball in open space. You know what he can do, and you got away from that. But again, congratulations to the Rams. Congratulations to the organization. Congratulations to Matt. And I'm just so excited for Super Bowl. We have the underdog and the Cinderella team in the Cincinnati Bengals. And we have the LA Rams, a team that has had its ups and downs throughout the year. Both teams have weathered storms, and this should make for great competitive football. So I'm excited, man. I'm excited. I am happy. But, man, thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you guys for the support. Man, I'm so excited for this week. And if I could say some encouraging tidbits to you guys. Again, there's no bar that's too high that you can't get to. No mountain, nothing. Everything is all a mental aspect. If you want it, go get it. Put it in the grind. Put it in the sweat. Don't allow anything to deter you or just really, you know what, make you feel discouraged about any dream or goal that you have. Go after it. We only have one life. Again, be good to people. You never know. Treat people with dignity and respect and continue to put that best foot forward every day. I hope you guys have a beautiful and blessed week. Thank you for tuning in. And until we meet again, this is The Breakdown, X's and O's with Nate Ness. Everybody have a beautiful and blessed day and Happy New Year.